Today I'm doing one of my favourite things, which is covering an unusual old recording format. Now, I've done quite a few videos about these over the years, and every now and then someone will get in touch to say, what are you going to do when you run out of them? Well, there's no need to worry about that, because when that happens, I can just start making them up. After all, who's going to believe that in this box here, I've got a device that can play back recordable paper? I mean, as if that was ever a thing. Right, so let's open that case up, take the machine out and have a good look at it. This is something I've been trying to find for a couple of years now in working order, and this one's in really good condition. Inside the case we've also got some paper for it and the microphone. And the machine in question is the 3M Soundpage system. This is an educational tool that made its debut in the US in 1974. Now, whilst it was sold there by 3M, it wasn't manufactured by them. It was imported from Japan and it was made there by Ricoh. Now, Ricoh sold this at home, as well as in some other countries, under the name the Ricoh Synchrofax. Now, I can find mention of that name going back to 1959. Now, back then, Ricoh's business was office equipment, and the Synchrofax was launched as an office tool, a dictation-type device. However, sometime between 1959 and 1974, it found a niche in the educational market, and the product was effectively relaunched as an educational tool, and that's the version of the machine that made its way to the US in 1974. And sure enough, before it found its way into my hands, my 3M Soundpage system was the property of the Oklahoma Educational Department. Right, so let me give you a quick demonstration. You open the lid, you put your piece of paper on the machine, close the lid on top of it, and press play.
It's puzzle time. We're going to fit the words bat, hat, fat, and mat in stories. There is a lady in the circus that all the people come to see because she is so... What word fits in my story? Draw a line from the first picture to that word. Did you draw a line from the picture to the word fat? The numeral 3 is next to the word fat. There is a lady in the circus that all the people come to see because she is so fat. Good. It's time to clean your windows and finish for today.
Now, don't know about you, but that gave me a bit of a creepy vibe. There's something just a little bit unnerving about it, but if you think that's weird, just wait till later on. Anyway, let's have a look how this works. So on this side it's just a normal piece of paper, but on the reverse it's covered in the same kind of material you get on magnetic tape. Now, whilst this particular piece of technology might date back to 1959, the idea of coating paper in materials like ferric oxide and recording on them is nothing new. Some of the first open reel recorders used paper reels of tape with special coatings. Perhaps the most unusual thing about this machine is the fact that the paper or recording material stays still, and it's the recording head that does all the moving. Now, this is the speed that it moves at whilst the device is playing. Down at the bottom is the record and play head, and as the device rotates, this gradually moves in towards the centre. It does this over a period of 4 minutes. That's the maximum amount of recording time you can get on one page. Now, when it reaches the end, it will automatically return, but if you want to, you can manually return it if you were to stop the page at an earlier point. You can fast forward and rewind, and whilst you're doing this, the recording, if there was a sheet on top of there, would be getting played back. It's designed to be easy to use. You can imagine a classroom full of children, each with one of these on their desks with their headphones plugged into it. They'll need to be able to operate it on their own. And the play button in the middle is also the stop button. It's a toggle switch. And at certain points in the programs, it instructs the user to stop the recording, to draw a picture or answer a question, and then press play when they're finished. And when they do press play, it continues from where they left off.
These words all begin with the letters SH. Are your windows nice and clean, girls and boys? Girls and boys? Are your windows nice and clean? Won't you show me? 2 for 1. It's lots of fun, as you can plainly see. S and H together make the sound we hear as shh, shh, shh. So say it after me. Shh. And meet Shelley the shoemaker in his shoe shop.
I'm Shelley the shoemaker. I'm short and a little shy. Shoes? Shoestring. Now, show me what you've learned. Let's shift to the picture. What you've learned. Let's shift to the picture of the shore.
One of the things that fascinates me about these is how good they still sound after all these years. Just imagine how many children have handled these pages roughly and they still sound as good as they originally did, I'd imagine. Now, the copyright date on them is 1974. That's not necessarily the date that these were printed, but theoretically they could be that old. Now, as well as those children's titles and introductions to maths, there's some more advanced titles here. Let's just have a quick listen to this one.
You have heard lots of statements. For instance, you have heard the statement, the Earth is round. When scientists first started making that statement, most people didn't believe it. They thought the Earth was flat because it looked flat. They wouldn't believe the Earth was round until the scientists proved it. Even though they were wrong about the Earth being flat, these people were right to want proof. Anybody can make a statement.
Now, whilst I was researching this video, one of the articles I found was from this company that had trained people on how to use these devices in education. In particular, they trained people to use them in a detention centre. It seems the sound page, with its combination of images and audio in an easy-to-use format, was something that found itself particularly suited for educating people with learning difficulties. As well as the prepared programs, you could also get your own blank pages so you could draw or photocopy your information onto one side and record your own audio on the other. Now, these ones looked blank, but when I put them into my machine, they revealed a bit of a story. I've edited some of it together for you here. Just have a listen to this.
The teacher should now say,
"This picture is to be someone you know very well, so it should be the best of all. I want each of you to make a picture of yourself, your whole self, not just your face."
While the children are drawing, stroll about the room and encourage those who are slow or who seem to be having difficulty by saying, "These drawings are very fine. You boys and girls are doing very well."
By referring to the attached sheets on sound page 5, we will now begin to score the drawing. Item number 1. Head present. Any clear method of representing the head. Features alone without any outline for the head itself are not credited for this point. Now look at the drawing. This drawing has a head, so place a plus in the blank after the 1.
Total up or count all the pluses that you have. You should have a raw score of approximately 48. To convert this raw score of 48 to IQ score, you will now have to change to sound page number 8.
The idea of those teachers scoring children's IQs based on self-portraits and whether or not they'd drawn a head on them made me feel a little bit melancholy. But then, this cheered me up no end. Somehow the kids have managed to get hold of this soundpage system and those old teachers' recordings and recorded music off the radio over the top of them. Let's just have a quick listen.
The exploration of new items which might increase the
There are quite a few of these, and given the names of the tracks and the artists, I think they all date from 1996, although perhaps the children should have spent a little bit more time practicing their spelling.
Paper Records brings you all the greatest hits from 1996 from such top artists as Allianz Borseet, Clelion Dane, Jewel, and Keith Sweat. Also, numerous assorted tracks, all with love in the title. This compilation is not available in any stores. It can only be found on misappropriated school equipment.
Well, as the saying goes, if you can't beat them, join them.
Thank you. time to clean your windows and finish for today.
Yes, make sure you delete those browsing cookies. Anyway, that's it for the moment. As always, thanks for watching.